BioVivacious. As you know, BioVivacious is a YouTube channel dedicated to clear fundamental concepts of biosciences. Today what we are going to do is we are trying to understand electron transport system. Prior to understanding electron transport system, we need to know what are the requirements for electron transport system. So the requirements for electron transport, requirements for carrying out electron transport is, there is a requirement for ADP molecules, because ultimately we need to make ATP. There is a requirement for inorganic phosphate. There is a requirement for NADH, and there is a requirement for FADH2 molecules. And we also require a whole set of enzymes. Enzymes and other proteins. So these are our requirements. We need ADP, we need inorganic phosphate, NADH is needed, FADH2, and a whole set of enzymes and proteins. Let us see how these molecules are made available in the mitochondrial matrix so that oxidative phosphorylation can be carried out. This is the fascinating story of this particular session. If you look at these molecules, what is very noteworthy is, though ATP molecules are produced inside, they are transported. Most of their work is outside the mitochondria. So the work of ATP in the cytoplasm or elsewhere. So therefore, ADP and inorganic phosphate is made in the cytoplasm. NADH, most of the NADH is made in the mitochondrial matrix, yet there are pathways where NADH is made in the cytoplasm, like glycolysis. FADH2, it is made in the mitochondrial matrix itself, there is no big issue about it. So when we need to transport them back into the mitochondrial matrix, bring them back. Now this transportation has four reasons why it has to be transported. Why there are four reasons are, first of all we have seen that in the cytosolic ADP, inorganic phosphate, NADH, these all must find an entry into the mitochondrial matrix. So that is the first reason. Cytosolic molecules must be transported back into the mitochondrial matrix. Second reason is, there are certain molecules which are present in the mitochondria. For example, you take oxaloacetic acid, okay, or you take acetyl-CoA. So these are produced in the mitochondrial matrix. They must be transported into the cytoplasm for carrying out certain reactions. For example, oxaloacetic acid is needed for synthesizing glucose. That will occur in the cytoplasm. Acetyl-CoA must be transported to the cytoplasm in order to have fatty acid synthesis. So you see, there has to be a very efficient transport system in mitochondria in order to carry out these functions. That is a second reason for an efficient transport system in the mitochondria. And the third reason is, ATP, which is produced in the mitochondrial matrix, must be transported out into the cytoplasm to carry out several functions. Most of the important functions of ATP is signal transduction, maintaining the ionic balance, movement, muscle movement. So these are some of the most important functions of ATP molecules. So therefore, ATP must be transported out. Okay, and the final reason is, I have already mentioned, okay, ADP and inorganic phosphate, because they have a different mechanism of being transported back into the system. So the four points I'm repeating: cytosolic entry of NADH, a different system; cytosolic entry of ADP and PI through a different system; oxaloacetic acid, acetyl CoA, which is formed in the mitochondrial matrix, must be transported out for synthesizing these molecules, and ATP, which is produced in the mitochondrial matrix, must be transported out. Let us look at each of these. Let us begin with the ADP molecules. When we talk about ADP molecules, inner mitochondrial matrix, that plays a key role to transport ADP into mitochondrial matrix. Remember, in an earlier session we mentioned that inner mitochondrial membrane is not going to allow any charged species to come inside. And remember, ADP has a 3 minus charge. It will not be allowed to come inside. Moreover, inner portion of the mitochondria is negatively charged. There will be repulsion. It will not allow a negatively charged molecule to be brought inside. What is the mechanism? This is the place we need a protein. And the name of the protein is ATP, ADP translocase. ATP, ADP translocase, it was isolated and identified in 1980 by a scientist known as Martin Klengenberg in 1980. Beautiful work. So this particular protein, it is a dimeric protein. So in the dimeric protein, molecular weight is about 32 kilodalton of this translocase. So this dimeric protein, it can take two shapes. Okay, two conformations, that's the right word. Two conformations. One conformation is moving, opening in this direction. Another conformation is opening in this direction. Another conformation is opening in this direction. If you consider this is the inner mitochondrial membrane and this is the mitochondrial matrix, now it will open in this direction, conformation, so whatever is attached here will be released into the matrix, and then it opens in this direction, whatever is attached, it is released into this site, that is in the cytoplasmic site. Let us represent in the form of a figure. So therefore, this particular protein, this is the conformation number one. Okay, so therefore, let us put it this way. So this way, membrane, this is the inner mitochondrial membrane. This is the inner mitochondrial membrane, and this is the matrix side. Okay, and this is the cytosolic side. Now remember, matrix side is negatively charged and cytosolic side is positively charged, and it is a relative positive charge. What normally happens is, you know that in matrix, ATP molecules will be more. The concentration is high in the matrix side, and it has got 4 minus charges. Okay, 4 minus charges. Now, because of the 4 minus charge and inside being negative, there is going to be a repulsion. It wants to get rid of the ATP molecules and become less charge inside. So it will always welcome an ADP which is 3 minus inside. So this protein has one binding site. Assume this is the binding site. To this binding site, an ATP binds. So when an ATP binds to that site, now what happens is, this is the figure number 2, conformation number 2. So okay, so this is, now this becomes the cytosolic side, this is the matrix side, this is negatively charged, this is positively charged. Okay, now what will happen is, ATP is bound here. When it opens into the other direction, here comes ADP. ADP will fight for this binding site. and ADP molecule will displace this ATP. It will displace the ATP. Okay, it is displaced and ADP binds here. ADP binds, fighting for that site. Once ADP binds with the 3 minus charge, again it comes back to this. It comes back to this conformation. It opens inside to the matrix side. When it opens, either ADP is released, because ATP molecule has a 30 times more affinity towards this particular binding site. Repeating, it has a 30 times more affinity towards that binding site. Therefore, ADP is released inside, ATP binds, conformation changes, ATP is released inside, ADP binds, conformation changes, ATP release, ADP release, ATP binds, conformation changes. This story will keep on repeating. This is how ATP molecules are transported out of the mitochondrial matrix and ADPs are taken inside. Beautiful story that is constantly happening in our system. So with this understanding, let us see how inorganic phosphate is transported inside. So inorganic phosphate, as you know, it is a byproduct of ATP hydrolysis. It forms ADP and inorganic phosphate. Now inorganic phosphate, it will have, I'll put H here. So it will have 2 minus charge. So you know that negatively charged species are not allowed to come inside. So what is proposed mechanism? Not so much of clarity on this. What is the proposed mechanism is a PiH plus symport mechanism, which means an H plus will bind here and it neutralizes this charge. H plus will bind, neutralizes this charge, and Pi molecules are brought in, camouflaged. Okay, that is how inorganic phosphate is brought back into the mitochondrial matrix.